held in honor by all. It becometh those who enter therein to weigh with reverent mind what the word of God teacheth concerning it. St. Paul, writing the first letter to the Corinthians, said, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecy, it will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect. But when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in the mirror face to face. Now I know in part. Then I shall understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. So faith, hope, love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. Our Lord, writing the Gospel according to St. Matthew, said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men shall revile you, persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For so men persecuted the prophets who were before you. May God bless the reading and the hearing of his word. Martha and Bruce, in 7 minutes, the two of you are going to make an important promise to each other. Having to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death parts you. There is hardly a more important promise you will ever make in your entire lives. For it, promise involves commitment, total, complete, unlimited, and irrevocable commitment. It is, humanly speaking, something like a contract or a compact. What God sets apart from all other contracts and compacts is that it is not initiated by human beings, but rather given by God. Hear Jesus' words. Have you not read that he who made them from the beginning made them male and female and said, for this reason shall a man be father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one? So they are no longer two, but one. But therefore if God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Since therefore marriage is a God-given institution, in and of itself it carries with it a blessing. Surely we know that there could hardly be any finer blessing in life than a good man. But blessings of this kind are not like some magical dust or magical sand, which when sprinkled over people makes everything right, enables them in some storybook fashion to live happily ever after. Not at all. God's blessing must be received in such a way that our spirits reflect His Spirit. When they do, we succeed. When they don't, we fail. This is abundantly clear in the Old Testament, the experience of ancient Israel. God's challenge to them was this: I will be your God. You shall be my people. As long as the people of Israel lived as God's people, they enjoyed prosperity. Not measured in economic terms, but in terms of satisfaction. When they forgot that they were God's people, they came on bad days indeed. How can we live as God's people? Jesus gave us a clue in the gospel lesson I just read. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness. Blessed are the merciful. Blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the peacemakers. You know, we could spend a long time talking about any one of those individual beatitudes. Suffice it to say that they provide for us an excellent guide to Christian living. And let it also be said that each and every one expresses the truth. The finest and most enriching blessings of life come to those who are willing to share blessings with others. Nowhere, Bruce, Martha, do we have a more appropriate place for this to happen than in marriage? Some time ago, I came across an old formula entitled The Art of Marriage. It begins, a good marriage must be created. In the marriage, the little things are the big things. It concludes, it is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right one. A prayer this morning, gathered in God's house, is that the two of you are indeed marrying the right person. But that shall only be known and only be true as each of you, with God's help, endeavors to be the right partner. Allow yourself, Bruce, Martha, to be richly blessed in marriage by being a blessing to each other. Amen. Into this holy estate, this man, this woman, are now to be united. If anyone therefore can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him now speak, or else forever hold his peace. Bruce, wilt thou have this woman to thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as ye both shall live? One. Wilt thou have this man, thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as he both shall live. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man? According to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my trust. I, Martha, take thee, Bruce, to my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death parts us, according to God's holy ordinance, thereto I pledge thee my trust. Represent endless faithfulness in that. First of all, Bruce, with this ring, put it among us and repeat after me. Receive this ring as a token of wedded love and trust.
Of wedded love and trust.
Bruce, can you repeat after me? Receive this ring. As a token of wedded love and trust. Let me join our leader. For as much as Bruce and Martha have been set together in holy wedlock and have declared the same before God and in the presence of this company, I pronounce them husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. What God hath joined together, let no one put asunder. The Lord God, who created our first parents, and sanctified their union in marriage, sanctify and bless you, that you may please him both in body and soul, live together in holy love until your life sing. Amen. The congregation will rise for prayer. Mighty and most merciful God, who has now united this man and woman in the holy estate of matrimony, grant them grace to live therein according to thy holy word. Strengthen them in constant fidelity and true affection toward each other. Sustain and defend them amidst all trials and temptations, and help them so to pass through this world faith toward thee, in communion with thy holy church, and in loving service one of the other, that they may enjoy forever thy heavenly benediction, through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. Amen. O God, who art our dwelling place in all generations, look with favor upon the homes of our land, enfold husbands and wives, parents and children, in the bonds of thy pure love, and so bless our homes, that they may be a shelter for the defenseless, a bulwark for the tempted, a resting place for the weary, and a foretaste of our eternal home in thee, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Please join me in praying together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I am pleased to introduce to you this morning Dr. and Mrs. Bruce Geary. Thank you.
right.
Right, yeah.
How did I know that? No, hey, I was thinking it's not.
Yeah, he's doing pretty different. What, 5 years since you were home?
Three at Christmas. Well, we're going to take some of the sanctuary first. My wife. Sherry. And that's Anne Marie. And Chrissy.
Hello.
Hi.
Thank you. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
What? What?
About 90 bucks that I can shoot. All dedicated.
Now, anybody want to shoot this, go ahead and shoot this, and then I'm going to
We ought to.
We could sell it.
We're fine. Just take a picture here.
So kind of fun.
Okay.
Now,
groups, stay where you are. Oh, it's a better one coming
up. I don't think so. Just get their attention. Don't do something. Don't be too obnoxious, but get their attention. Be
obnoxious.
Hi, Betty.
He's dangerous with that baby, you know?
Trouble is, it doesn't make it even harder.
Yeah, okay. You can fix it a while, I'll get the other. Okay.
You're still such a good job.
Hey, Bruce.
What?
You pull that one string, the whole gun falls apart.
We're supposed to be going in, right? Turning for each other. Okay, and this looks like line back this way a little bit. A little bit more.
Thank you.
quite a bit of thorough investigation into married life. So, with that investigation, and now that they're married, shall we all raise our glasses? All right. May you both share the joys and rewards of the research in each other. Rubbing up everywhere.
Pressure on you.
Hey, that's right. I didn't want to. You know, it went foot. So, yeah, I was very, very excited. Well, actually, I guess that was only me. She decided that was one reason. After that, it was just. For her.
Every little bundle. I blew you already. Hey, you know.
Hi, Doug here from Light Beer from Miller. Thank you, friend.
Not here, not here. You have a good time?
Excellent.
Where are you, the captain?
Who's the owner?
How?
You blow up at the same time?
Yeah. More exciting. Yeah.
Throw the guys out.
Yeah.
that guy out of the way. Get him out of the way.
Coming down. It's really coming down. really coming down.
That's fucking coming down.
Why is it dropping like a rock?
It's really faint. See it?
They're staying pretty low.
Yeah,
the others are pretty high.